Because love sucks. When you have just broken up with someone, yeah, it sucks. But when you first start out with someone, it's beautiful.
First, well, it all seems quite a lark. You like someone, he likes you.
The best thing about love is the first thing about love.
You feel confident, which is rare. Wholly confident.
Everything is fun and affection.
You feel like if the world were annihilated at that very minute and you're with that person, it's okay.
Then all at once, those fine thoughts of love and affection can suddenly get twisted.
The worst thing about love is that you could lose that person at any time.
And when the relationship ends, and our relationships do end,
you just go through this intense review of your life.
Welcome to the Denise Show. As you know, Denise is the girl who broke up with me 5 weeks ago. Wasn't that big a deal. She ripped open my chest and pulled out my heart.
Yesterday, he said he loved you. Today, you see him kissing your best friend. You turn on the TV one day, and your girlfriend is on Montel telling the world she's never had an orgasm. If you haven't already been hurt by love, look out, you will be. It could be the difference between being kissed and being kissed off.
Well, it's over. It's definitely over.
She broke up with you.
No, but I can tell she's going to. I can sense it.
Some of the warning signs that someone's going to break up with you are the distancing technique, the slow removal of personal items from the house. Oh, there's my Prince tape. You haven't listened to that Prince tape in over 3 years. Why are you so interested in it?
Don't you understand? I need hand. I have no hand.
Break up with
her. What?
You break up with her. You reverse everything that way. A preemptive breakup.
When I start going out with a guy, one of the things I really check out is if he had a good breakup with his last girlfriend, if they're on good terms, because that could be me.
You're breaking up with me?
Yes. I am breaking up with you.
Wow.
Shocked?
I really am.
Never expected this, did you?
The warning signs? In my case, there aren't any.
I was completely and thoroughly blindsided.
I have broken off relationships. Sometimes capriciously, sometimes intentionally.
And basically, I broke their hearts. And they say what goes around comes around, and I definitely got it twice as bad.
I am breaking up with you.
You can't break up with me. I've got hand.
And you're gonna need it.
The meanest thing that anybody said to me when we were breaking up was, I always thought your poetry sucked.
When a woman left me and said, I'm leaving because I don't want to settle, that was bad. That was a bad feeling.
The meanest thing that she said to me was that our love was a toy love, that it wasn't real.
As he was walking out the door, he told me that I suck in bed.
My recent girlfriend said to me was that everything that I had done for her, I could have done for a dog. You.
I think we hurt the ones we love because we just can't avoid it.
You know what their vulnerabilities are. You know where their soft spots are.
Well, we don't always hurt the one we really love. We hurt the ones that we don't love anymore.
You won't be needing this.
Heartbreak to me feels like the heart has been ripped from your chest, smashed on the floor, stepped on, and utterly cremated.
I honestly felt as though my heart was breaking. I felt this incredible pain in my chest. The clenched gut, the, you know, lump in the throat.
I threw up a lot.
Sleepless nights, not eating.
I didn't eat for a while, so I had the heartbreak diet, which was a good thing.
I just flipped out. I smashed everything in our apartment, you know. Smashed the television set. Just went crazy.
I can't believe she did this to me. It's not fair. What did I do wrong, Denise? Just tell me and I'll stop doing it.
I believe that everybody does play the fool at some point or another in a relationship.
Yeah, sure. Everyone plays the fool at some point. And in my case, maybe more often than I care to admit.
If you haven't, then you haven't experienced love. You don't know what love is if you haven't been rejected. Because how else would you know?
Growing up, every young girl dreams of their wedding day. I think women are taught from a very young age that you're going to be this beautiful princess in your white dress, and your Prince Charming is going to come up on his white horse, and you're going to have this dream wedding. So when it finally comes, you want your wedding day to be absolutely perfect. I think I fell in love with Dave right away. I really felt like it was love at first sight. We went on vacation together and spent a week at the beach together and just had a great time. And I thought, well, this is the person I want to be with. And I felt that right from the beginning, that I want to spend the rest of my life with this person. It was very strong, intense feelings. Within 5 months, I moved in with him, and then 2 months later, he asked me to marry him. So it happened very quickly, but it was exciting. I felt like I was swept off my feet by him. Dave was not very involved in the wedding plans. He kind of said, this is your show, you run with it. I chose the church because I'd always wanted to be married at Hines Chapel. Ever since I was a little girl, I always loved this church. I wanted a dress that was very elegant, very sophisticated, and that was going to look nice for an evening wedding. I was so wrapped up in the wedding and consumed by it that I kind of ignored some things that were going on between Dave and I. He started to withdraw. He was going out with his friends a lot. He would say things like, well, why don't we just wait? Or, you know, let's just live together. Maybe we need some more time. I was like, well, wait a minute. Why did you ask me in the first place? So that bothered me. But also, I kind of pushed it to the back and said, I'm not going to worry about it. Let's just get him to the altar. He'll be fine. A week before the wedding, we had to go get the marriage licenses. And I had kind of been bugging him about it all week. And finally, I said, Dave, when can you go get the licenses? And he said, I can't do this. And I said, what do you mean? Do you have a meeting today? Are you really busy this morning? He said, no, I can't get married. And I went to work and was so upset. I had a horrible time working that day. I got home and he said, I called my guests and called my family and said that we're postponing it. And it was such a shock. Like, oh my God, he's really serious. He means business. He doesn't want to do this. And that was just the worst feeling. And then, of course, I went into a rage. Got a little upset. I wanted someone to yell at and be angry. And he was gone. This is probably the worst thing that's ever happened to me in my life. Up until now, I had a very normal, happy life. And that's how I thought life was going to be. You think to yourself, why doesn't this person love me? Why doesn't this person want to marry me? Am I that bad of a person? So it's very easy to lose your self-esteem and your self-confidence over something like this. But if you're a strong person to begin with, you realize that you're going to get through it and that you are a good person. So I have like 200 thank you cards in a big box ready to be thrown away, I guess. I don't know. This is our wedding announcement. A June 11 wedding is planned. Was planned. Never happened. So glad I can have a sense of humor about this. We're going to cook out. We're going to have a weenie roast. Yeah. I was overwhelmed at how supportive people were. My friends were great. Anytime I was down, I called, or they would call me and say, how's everything going? Do you need anything? No man allowed. Boys are bad. Some of them had ill feelings towards Dave, but I think that's to be expected.
So how's he feeling about the wedding?
Why do men think that you have to do the rebound?
I don't know.
It's his $4,000.
He broke it off. He should have thought of that before he called off the wedding.
I had a lot of friends say, oh, move on with your life, you know, get rid of them. You don't need this stuff and so on and so forth. That's very easy for someone to say, but only you know what's best for you.
I think you learn through relationships. You learn about who you are and what you want from someone else, and it makes you stronger. Somehow this will make me stronger. I haven't figured out how it's going to make me stronger, but
Deep down, I know it will.
This weekend, MTV's All Jammed Up. Warm up with the top jams of all time countdown, hosted by Shaq. Then, You're in the House, Snoop Doggy Dogg's house, and Dr. Dre's house, where Ice Cube's hanging out. It's two very special MTV Jam special editions. And count it down with the superstars in the MTV Jams Countdown NBA edition. MTV Jams Countdown Weekend with special guest Shaq. All this weekend on MTV. Plug in, count down, and jam on.
No place to go.
My family was shot down by undercover cops.
When you need a professional on your side,
bullet slide off. You're indestructible.
He's the best there is. From the celebrated director of La Femme Nikita, The Professional, rated R, at theaters November 18th.
Where can you find jeans called Arizona?
In canyons, underwater, and inside shells.
JCPenney!
Under bridges, underground, and in outer space.
You see, you can find Arizona Jean Company jeanswear just about everywhere. But you can only buy it at JCPenney. And at our prices, it's a real find.
Like some vegetable, but no plant could be so smart as to pick one machine that plays Sega Genesis and Sega CDs. That's the JVC XI. She could care. Put your mind to work, she says. I say XI comes with Compton's Interactive Encyclopedia. Hey, it's a CD player, plus you get stuff for free. So now it's see what you can do when you apply yourself? One mind, one machine. XI, multi-entertainment system. Call 1-800-JVC-XI.
MTV changed my life. I had become heavily involved in the Church of Divine Love.
Scum-sucking demon horse!
We spent most of our time listening to inspirational tapes and demonstrating against schools which taught tolerance of homosexuals. We got arrested, too. One night at our church barbecue, we received a disturbing report. Sister Evelyn described in shocking detail how her children's minds were being poisoned by music videos on MTV. I was determined to see this horror for myself. Nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. I was strangely moved and attracted.
Now I don't have such a narrow view of people who are different. And neither does Evelyn.
When somebody leaves you, your ego is usually the worst sufferer. And if you can exact any sort of petty revenge, it's just a little patch on your ego.
Gene's slap didn't hurt his face, but it certainly injured his pride. He tried to laugh it off, but he was thinking that he'd have to get even.
When you get revenge on someone, when someone just has to eat what they made you eat, it's just this total macho, like, yes, like, you know, deal with that.
What am I supposed to do? You won't answer my calls, you change your number. I'm not gonna be ignored, Dan.
Don't get mad, get even. It sounds good, but really, when love goes bad, what can you do? Buy a gun from a high school classmate and shoot your lover's wife in the head on her front porch? Burn his multi-million dollar mansion down to the ground after a late night argument? Cut off his penis with a knife and toss it out your car window? Who's crazy enough to do something like that?
I've always wanted to take revenge on my boyfriends.
Where'd you get that gun?
Take a good look at it, Joe. Take a good look at the gun.
To this day, I think about it. I should have done this. I should do this.
Well, it's too late, Joe. I'm going to kill you.
I live my fantasy in that I have the opportunity to get up in front of people and talk about my ex-lovers, sometimes by name.
Listen, Melissa. Melissa, listen. Listen, Melissa. Melissa, listen. Listen, Melissa. 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 Melissa.
I have a number of poems that directly address ex-lovers and say everything I wish I could have said to them.
You are a manicured, masturbating little brat, and I'm going to leave you, and I'm going to take my clothes.
I've gotten to say it all. Not directly to their faces, but to large groups of anonymous strangers.
All right, now's the time in the show when I like to give Denise a call and hang up on her. That was great.
I would drive past the house, call and hang up, you know, be sure I was seen with somebody, whatever, little vengeful things.
I don't know how to say this, Dave, but I mean, I'm dating Jimmy Dawson.
Well, your boyfriend better watch out.
When my girlfriend Kathleen left me for another man, I felt this incredible rivalry with him. I just wanted to make his life a living hell, like any way that I could. I wanted him to like get any kind of a clue of what, you know, pain that I was feeling. I don't know why, it's very immature. I didn't want any revenge on Kathleen. I just wanted her to like, well, I guess I did in a way. I wanted Kathleen to break down and say, you were right all along. Please take me back.
Hey. Revenge is not a way to cope with a breakup at all. You're not about to let all the air out of his tires, so he'll call you up and say, you know, you're letting all the air out of my tires, made me realize how much I really care about you and love you. Let's get back together.
You can't make the other person love you again. You can never argue your way out of dumped.
Hello, Denise.
Why can't you get it? It is over. You and me are over. Face reality. We're not a couple. Move on with your life.
Will you go back out with me?
No!
Then the show must go on.
In theory, I don't really feel revenge is good, but when people hurt me, I want to hurt them back the same. Roger was my instructor at the ballroom dance classes I was taking. He was a charmer from the very start. He looked at me the first day and he said, I can tell there's something special about you. He was very smooth and he made me feel beautiful. He made me feel beautiful even when I was stepping on his toes. He would give me all kinds of gifts. He gave me a watch that was really expensive. I was completely swept off my feet. One day when I was leaving the dance studio, a girl came over to me and she pulled my wrist over to her and she said, that's my watch. And I was like, no, I'm sorry. This was a gift from my boyfriend. And she said, oh, you mean Roger. And she told me that he wanted to marry her, that he saw that she was special, everything that Roger had also said to me. My first reaction was, get home and look at my jewelry. Sure enough, the ring that my grandmother had given me was gone, and it was a family heirloom. Then I felt
disgusted. Disgusting. Used. Stupid. Embarrassed. When I confronted him, he was nervous, and I felt in my heart that he was a fraud, a con, and he had taken the ring. After that, I never heard from him again. He was gone. Now, as the time is going by, I'm getting angry because he tricked me. I want revenge. Can you help
revenge.
Me?
We all want revenge. You can get your revenge by lighting a justice candle, and then what he took from you, he'll lose threefold.
Okay, I want that justice candle. Watch out, Roger. Philip Seldon teaches a course in revenge. It's all about how to get revenge without breaking the law.
Etching powder in the underwear, really great thing to do, is methyl ethyl red. You put this in someone's drink, and when they go to the bathroom, it comes out red.
After getting all the advice from Philip, I decided to go to some ballroom dance classes in New York and blacklist him from the world of dance studios.
Quick, slow, quick, beautiful.
I wanted to come by to warn you and your students about a man who's teaching ballroom dance.
My teachers do not date their students.
And she recognized her watch on my wrist.
What?
It doesn't usually happen though, let me tell you.
I hope you come back, and I hope you come back here. I would love your business. You're a lovely young lady.
Thanks.
Beautiful leg.
I don't know if I feel revenge is good, but for me it was important to get it out because I felt like it was eating me up inside. I just want justice.
Just how many wacky adventures can two stupid white boys have?
Hey, baby.
Ow! You little perp!
The quest for an answer continues. New Beavis and Butthead. A new adventure every night. Tonight at 11. I'm saying plug into it.
This job would be great if it wasn't for the customers.
Do you have that one with that guy who was in that movie that was out last year?
You should hear the barrage of stupid questions I get.
What do you mean there's no ice? You mean I gotta drink this coffee hot?
Miramax Films is proud to present an outrageous new look at the over-the-counter culture.
You think anybody can see us down here?
Why? Do you want to have sex or something?
Can we?
Clicks. Just because they serve you doesn't mean they like you.
You hate people.
But I love gatherings. Isn't it ironic?
Rated R. Now playing at select theaters.
Introducing Alien vs. Predator for the 64-bit Atari Jaguar. You might not want to play it alone.
Mom.
Coverage of the pack. Count on the Emmy Award-winning TV6 sports team. Talking Packers, Sundays on the TV6 News at 10.
In the future, successful cities will have efficient mass transit systems. Businesses will depend upon them, visitors will be drawn to them, and residents will demand them. That is why our elected officials are considering light rail. Light rail is our opportunity to wisely utilize the promise of 80% federal funding for a transit project in our region. It's our chance to build a transportation system that will grow as we grow. Planning for a Milwaukee light rail system must continue. Our future depends upon it.
Whoa.
thin they felt like, and all of a sudden it's like they just drop off the face of the earth. It happens that fast. Goodbye. It's over. See ya.
I thought, now I know what death feels like. That did occur to me. I was like, this is a death. It's a death of like a huge part of my life.
Breakups in a lot of ways are worse than death because that person's still walking around. You're gonna bump into them with another girl, and that just sucks.
Gone. Was it good sex?
Don't do this,
David. Can you just tell me that, Dee? Was it good? What are you hesitating for? Just tell me, was it good? Was it good? Was it good?
Yes. That's the way love goes.
They say time heals a broken heart, but they say that about a broken leg, too. It's a little comfort. And just when you think you're over it, something reopens the wound.
Whenever I go any place that we went together, I basically think of him. There's a certain train here in the city that we rode to go to our apartment a lot. And sometimes I ride that train and it's like all I think about is him.
It's the same with holidays. You'll remember we were here at this time last year. We were doing this, we were doing that.
When I was going through the breakup and listening to pop radio, I just realized how unbearable, it was absolutely unbearable to listen to the songs because they were all just these insane cliches over and over again, you know. Like, when you're in love with a beautiful woman, you gotta watch your friends, like, oh.
The hardest part about our farewell was her coming to retrieve all her stuff. It's difficult because that's the finality of it, you know? I mean, when the stuff is gone, there's no reason to come back.
There are ways to finesse the post-breakup period to minimize your pain and agony.
I try to keep busy and just do things.
Running every day, just forever.
I bought tons of clothes. I went shopping.
I rely on a lot of corny personal affirmation techniques.
I'm okay. My life is not worthless.
It's just life experience. And I think you just gotta like, okay, chalk it up, get on.
When a girl loses a steady, it takes a little while to get back in circulation.
It's really impossible to say how long it takes for somebody to get over a breakup. The formula that I've heard is that it takes twice as long as the relationship actually lasted.
2 weeks for every month you were together, I think. That's how long. It's scientifically proven.
But if you want to meet boys, you go where boys are.
There is no set time on what it takes to heal from a breakup with somebody. But eventually, you move on. You start to look at other people of the opposite sex and say, oh, I find that person attractive, and realize that you have the ability to love again.
I think it's really going to be hard for me to fall in love again.
It gets more difficult to trust people every time.
When you've been hurt so badly, you don't want it to happen again, and you're going to protect yourself.
I've been to 5 weddings this year, and every single one of the brides said at one point or another, I will never love again, I'll never find him, and now they're all married. Everyone thinks that they're never going to find love again after a breakup, but you will, because you have to. Love hurts. Love scars.
Love moves. And love definitely sucks. You wonder sometimes, was it worth it?
Now I'd be inclined to say no. By next weekend, I'll change my mind, I'm sure.
Being in love, for me, it's just unavoidable. Why even think about if it sucks or not? You just have no choice.
Really, what else is there besides love to make you get out of bed in the morning, put on a cute outfit, and keep trying?